Hello, my dear student. Welcome back to our class. Today we are going to start the another part of the study of compounds, that is sulfuric acid. So we'll study from this chapter the preparation of sulfuric acid. In the laboratory preparation we'll study, then we'll go for the chemical properties and the physical properties of sulfuric acid. Okay, so we can see first the molecular formula of sulfuric acid. The molecular formula of sulfuric acid is H2SO4. One molecule of H2SO4 contains, that means one molecule of sulfuric acid contains two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of sulfur and four atoms of oxygen. So we know how to calculate the molecular mass. We can add the atomic mass of each element, then we will get the molecular mass. So molecular mass of sulfuric acid is equal to 98. Okay, so this is the molecular mass of sulfuric acid, then this is the formula of sulfuric acid. Now we can see the structure of the sulfuric acid. Structure of the sulfuric acid. So sulfur will be the center atom. Then we know four oxygen atoms are surrounded sulfur. So four oxygen, then two hydrogen atom will be like this. So the structure of the sulfuric acid will be like this. Central atom will be sulfur. Then sulfur is bonded with one oxygen atom. Another oxygen atom, then it's bonded with another oxygen atom by coordinate bond. Okay, then this oxygen atom is bonded with one hydrogen atom and this oxygen atom is bonded with one other hydrogen atom. So this will be the structure of sulfuric acid. Then we know sulfuric acid, we are saying that it's the king of the chemical. Why? Because we can prepare large number of chemicals by using sulfuric acid. By using the sulfuric acid, we can prepare large number of chemicals. This is the reason we are calling H2SO4 as the king of the chemicals. Okay, the other name of H2SO4 is blue vitriol. Okay, this is another name of the sulfuric acid. Clear. Now we are directly going to the preparation part of the sulfuric acid. From this chapter we will only study the laboratory preparation of sulfuric acid. That industry method we will not study because it is excluded from the syllabus. So we can see how to prepare, or how can we prepare sulfuric acid in the laboratory. Okay, from this chapter only we will study the equations. We will not go for the experimental setup for the preparation of sulfuric acid. Okay. So we can prepare sulfuric acid by oxidation method, by oxidation of aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide, by the oxidation reaction of whose aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide we can prepare sulfuric acid. So first the reaction, aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide means SO2 plus H2O. Okay, this is aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide gas is dissolved in water. That is aqueous solution. Aqua means water. So oxidation. So we know definition of for oxidation, addition of oxygen is known as oxidation. Addition of electronegative elements are oxidation. So we will use that method for the preparation of sulfuric acid. So we are taking oxygen. So by the addition of oxygen on aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide, we can prepare sulfuric acid. We can see how. So SO2 will dissolve in water and oxygen gas also will dissolve in water. We will get H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Clear? Sulfuric acid we can prepare. So we need to balance this one. So I can put here 2. So sulfur is 1. Here sulfur is 2. So we should give 2 here. Now we can see oxygen is how many oxygens are there? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can see 4 into 2, 8. Okay, so this is balanced now. So addition, by addition of oxygen, addition of oxygen is known as oxidation. By oxidation method we can prepare sulfuric acid. Then we know addition of electronegative elements are also what? Oxidation. So we can see how, by the oxidation method we can prepare sulfuric acid. So I am taking aqueous solution of a sulfur dioxide, that is SO2 plus H2O. Then I am doing addition of chlorine, that is oxidation, because chlorine is electronegative element. We know definition for oxidation, addition of electronegative elements also what? Oxidation. So chlorine is electronegative element, so I am adding chlorine to this solution. I will get H2SO4 and HCl. okay, we need to balance this equation. So putting 2 here and then here. Now 4 hydrogen, 2 plus 2 is 4 hydrogen. Sulfur is 1, sulfur is 1. Oxygen is how many? 2 plus 2, 4. Here also 4. Chlorine is 2, chlorine is 2. Now this is balanced. We can see this is a simple reaction. We know we can prepare sulfuric acid by oxidation method. Oxidation of aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. So this is aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. Addition of oxygen is known as oxidation. So we got sulfuric acid. Addition of chlorine also what? Oxidation. So I got sulfuric acid. So next, addition of bromine. Electronegative halogens are electronegative elements. Addition of bromine, SO2 plus H2O, aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide, and I am adding bromine, Br2, give H2SO4 and HBr, 2 H2O. You can see here also electronegative elements are added, so it's produced H2SO4 and another gas, that is what, HBr gas. So it is very simple to prepare sulfuric acid. You can easily learn the reaction also. You have to keep in your mind, we can prepare sulfur dioxide by the oxidation method. Oxidation of whose? Aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. By the oxidation of aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide, we can prepare sulfuric acid. Clear? So addition of oxygen is known as oxidation. Addition of electronegative elements are also oxidation. So here addition of electronegative elements, Cl2. So this is oxidation. So we got H2SO4 and HCl. Clear? Then addition of bromine gas. That is also oxidation. So we got H2SO4 and corresponding acid. So that is bromic acid. This is the chloric acid. Clear? So we can see one more method to prepare sulfuric acid. By treating nitric acid with sulfur. You have already studied this reaction in the nitric acid chapter. Anyhow, we can see here again. We can prepare sulfuric acid by treating nitric acid with sulfur, or sulfur you can treat with in nitric acid. Okay, so we can see how the reaction. Sulfur plus HNO3 will give H2SO4 plus NO2 plus water. So you can see H2SO4 is formed. Here also H2SO4 is formed. H2SO4, H2SO4. So this is the preparation of sulfuric acid by oxidation method and by treating sulfur with nitric acid. Okay. So sulfur, we need to balance this equation. So I should give 2 here. So 2H2 and I have to give 2 here. Clear? Now this equation is balanced. So we have learned easily the preparation of sulfuric acid in the laboratory preparation. It's a laboratory preparation. Okay, laboratory preparation of sulfuric acid, right? How can we prepare sulfuric acid in the laboratory? We can prepare sulfuric acid in the laboratory by the oxidation of aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. Aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. So oxidation, addition of oxygen, that is oxidation. Addition of electronegative elements, that is also oxidation. So by the addition of oxygen, we will get sulfuric acid, H2SO4, this is H2SO4, okay? H2SO4, and next, addition of chlorine on aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide, will get sulfuric acid and HCl. Similarly, addition of bromine to the aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide, will get sulfuric acid and bromic acid. Clear? So after that, we all learned, we can prepare sulfuric acid by treating nitric acid with sulfur. So S plus HNO3 will give H2SO4, NO2 and water. So this reaction you need to by heart, because we will not study the other manufacturing of nitric acid, that is a contact process, actually manufacturing of nitric acid, but we will not study about that one. Okay, so I hope all of you understand the sulfuric acid preparation very easily. So please try to learn this equation. So thank you, students.